Hello everyone. In our previous sessions, we have discussed phase 1 and phase 2 of public relation program planning. So under which we have discussed identification of problem in phase 1 and communication planning in phase 2. So now we are moving towards phase 3 of process of PR, that is implementation or executing PR program. So, implementation program includes action planning. So, implementation program is always in line with the problem and objective of the PR plan, which we have done in phase 1 and phase 2 of PR process. So, the objective of public relation plan may be targeted towards creating awareness among your stakeholders or making announcement of certain new idea, new product, etc. or shift in attitude from negative to positive or shift in behavior, etc. So, the program decided in the planning stage is executed here. So, we can call it as execution phase. So here, a professionally prepared plan can be successful only if implemented seriously and meticulously. So management professionals always opine that action is a magic word, and possibly even a mediocre plan, when implemented vigorously and effectively, can produce outstanding result. So, a good plan, when implemented with professional seriousness, will surely make the program a grand success. So, that is why planning a public relation program meticulously and effectively is one of the important phase. So, the program which is going to add value to public relation program is maybe arranging the event. So that is decided in the planning stage of PR process. So where they are planning, they may be planned to host events like celebrating the anniversary, hosting open days or hosting HUMERS day, etc. Or they may plan for charities, donations and gifts for economically weaker section people. Or it may be a plan of having a CSR practice, corporate social responsibility practice. So it goes along with the study of socio-economic conditions, study of the people or target audience. So then the plan may be communicating your target audience through mass media messages or mass media text. So but even though we plan meticulously, we implement it very effective way, there may be certain problem which may hinder your action planning. So, we term public relation as a process of facilitating a change in the mindset of publics, because it is very sensitive issue, because here the action strategies are fraught with the several hurdles, roadblocks and speed breakers. So, human beings are always have strong tendency to resist to change, and this is known as very universal concept. So people, they don't accept a new idea or new concept very easily. So they have always tendency to resist first and then accept. What is the reason for that? So we know that human live for social conformity or social control, and it is a very big challenge to public relation officer when they plan to advocate an idea or value system which challenge the social conformity. So then what is the solution to tackle this problem? So the logical way is to find out reason to resistance to change. Many times people have, you know, adamant behavior that they express that they know everything. So we call it as all know disposition. Or they think that we don't receive any suggestion from outsider. So the logical way is to find out what is the reason for their resistance to change. So here a public relation officer can do by working out the plan of soften the attitude of resistance to change, and then finally converting them to ultimate acceptance of the changed value system. So, public relation officer can have a plan of showing them benefit of following certain idea, certain cause, etc., where he can demonstrate certain ideas. The ill effects of not adopting new idea or new change. So here public relation officer work out plan to soften the resistance to change attitude of the people. And finally, he can prompt them to ultimate acceptance of changed value system. So here what can he do is, he can show them the benefit of adopting certain ideas and adopting certain behaviors. And he can show the advantage of adopting certain ideas and certain behavior. So a demonstration techniques may help him a lot. Example for this, so if you are undertaking no smoking campaign or drink evil campaign, so people generally don't accept your idea of shifting from smoking to not smoking behavior. So if you show them or if you demonstrate them, so what happens them if they don't change their behavior, and what happens to them if they change the behavior? So demonstration can help a public relation officer a lot to fulfill his predetermined goal. So the next problem which a public relation officer will face is message management while implementing the public relation activity. So message management is considered as a major challenge. Message management starts with the message development, the delivery of message, feedback and registration of message in the minds of people. So we may have a very well described plan of action with us. But it's always dealing with the human climate, and we have to use a channel to reach out them. So there is a sizable risk of going aplog because there may be certain noise come in between the message while we delivering the message as well as while people receiving the message. So message management is the focused responsibility of a public relation professional. So what is the solution for this? So first of all, be creative in your message management. We have already discussed that creativity is considered as foundation for any public relation activity. So you should stand far from other messages delivered by other organization, and you should have a different message for a different audience. So in phase first of public relation process, you have to study your stakeholders first, and every stakeholder have different demographic and psychographic feature. So by studying their demographic and psychographic feature, you can have different message for different audience. So take for example, your employees may in need of different message, and your community members may have in need of different message, and your customers may in need of different messages. So you have to have a plan of different message for different audience, and then you have to change the strategy here and then. So you cannot keep same strategy for a long period of time. And then keep some catchy words constant so that you can brand the communication message, so that you can keep your communication plan intact. So the next challenge is handling mass media. Public relation is all about communicating information to the stakeholders. So you need a media. And for example, your event plan may be hosting a informal get together for media personnels, or issuing press release, or conducting press conference. But media personnel are very unpredictable. At the same time, getting space in media is very difficult job because they always reject any messages attached with business plan. So sometimes your all plan may go wrong. So that's why always look into the news value in the message so that you can easily get space in mass media. So in conclusion, public relation is not a one-time job. It needs constant monitoring of the public attitude and public opinion, and in the implementation stage, any updatable message should be considered for modification. The program should be flexible enough to incorporate mid-course corrections for the success of any public relation activity. So with this, I will conclude today's session and we'll meet again with another topic. Thank you.